Hi, I'm Rene Urbanovich, and I'm so excited to do this Voice Teacher Reacts on Kelly Clarkson at the American Idol Farewell Show. I love doing these because I want to explore creativity and how it impacts our culture and how it touches us on an individual level. And what better way than Voice Teacher Reacts, my favorite instrument, the voice. Please subscribe so that each time I do one, you won't miss any. Okay, so here we go. This is Kelly Clarkson, and I'm going to be the voice teacher that reacts.
Walking towards the airport, leaving us all in your past. I traveled 1,500 miles to see you. Begged you to want me, but you didn't want to.
Oh, I have to stop already. This is immediate, is it not? I'm not even there. So, what Kelly Clarkson is doing is telling us a story, and we're wired for story. We're wired to relate to the narrator and what she wants. And she wanted to be wanted. And this is about her dad. I've heard the song recorded. I've never watched her sing it. And so this is in real time. So I'm not even 34 minutes and she got me choked up already because of her story. They even cut the beginning of the song. There was no setup. And she said, I saw your back and you left me in your past. So already I'm feeling for her and I'm touched by her story and what she's had to overcome. Whew. So she just begged to be wanted. Let's see what happens next. And she just belted it out, obviously. She's got that husk in her voice. She's not holding back. She's not trying to sing properly. She's feeling it, right? Okay, keep going.
But piece by piece, he collected me up off the ground where you abandoned things. Yeah, piece by piece, he filled the holes that you burned in me. At 6 years old, and you know, he never walks away. He never asks for money. He takes care of me, cause he loves me. Piece by piece, he restored my faith that a man can be kind and a father could stay.
And she puts emphasis on the word stay. She doesn't sing it, stay. That would take us out of the emotion. So I think I could be wrong because I try not to do any research. I try and just allow these singers and the art to impact me, to influence me, so that I do have a human reaction. And I could be wrong, but it sounds like she's talking about her past, how her dad took off, and that I think she's now a mom and her husband is the he. He is collecting her. He is making her realize that a man can stay. He is healing her. I heard something once in the 90s, I think, in the year 2000, that and it was by a writer named Eldridge, John Eldridge, that we go throughout our lives, and of course we get wounded, and people stick arrows in us, right? They shoot arrows at us, and then we spend the rest of our time finding special people to remove those arrows. So it sounds to me like her husband is who's removing the arrows that her father shot into her. I could be wrong. This is just my interpretation with no research, but I'm very moved by her voice and by her story. If this is exactly what it's about, I don't know. But I think. Okay. More singing.
And all of your words, they fall flat. I made something of myself, and now you wanna come back. But your love, it isn't free, it has to be earned.
Okay, so it sounds to me now, sounds to me, this is the bridge. So this is where, in a song, it turns, right? So you have the chorus, which is the hook and the thing the song is about. And then the verses set up that chorus. And we repeat the chorus. And then when we get to the bridge, it's a different angle. It's like if you looked at the underneath side of a ship, then you describe that. So it sounds like he wants to come back and she wants to say, no, you don't get to come back. And if I recall, Justin Bieber didn't have a dad. And then when he got famous, yeah, he came along, right, and wanted back in his life. So sounds like Kelly Clarkson is drawing a little bit of a boundary. I'm assuming she wrote this and that it's her story because I know she did become a mom. Okay, I'm going to take it back just a little because I want to hear that bridge again.
But your love, it isn't free. It has to be earned. Back then I didn't have anything you needed, so I was worthless.
Ooh, okay. I don't know if that's good writing or not, but she just told it. I don't have to figure it out. She didn't have anything that her dad wanted, so she was worthless. And so, yeah, she's had it. I can't quite tell what she's saying. Your love isn't free. It comes at a cost, at a price. But, yeah, that must not feel good. And, you know, singing and writing are two really good things to do to process. So, obviously, she can afford a therapist. She's Kelly Clarkson. And, obviously, she has a good husband who's soothing her and healing her. But when you write a song about your pain and when you write in your journal and when you sing and you vibrate those feelings and process them so that they have a way to not block you in your life, it's really therapeutic. Huh. And I mean, I had a great dad and I'm still feeling it. I'm feeling it for her. And I'm loving her husband right now. And I'm really grateful that her kid is going to have this strong woman raise her. Woo.
Piece by piece, he collected me off the ground where you abandoned things. Yeah, piece by piece, he filled the holes that you burned in me. 6 years old, you know, he never walks away. He never asks for money. He takes care of me. He loves me. Piece by piece, he restored my faith that a man can be kind and a father could stay.
Oh. And the second time she says stay, she holds it out as form mirrors content. The content is the word stay, and the form is hold that note. Stay, because it's staying. The note is staying. It's representing what the man does. So she did a different thing there, which was unexpected. And when you whenever you do the unexpected, and it's not too repetitious, it can get to you. I have plumb forgot to talk about her voice because I'm so taken by the song. So her voice is hoarse. She's hoarse. She's a little bit at a deficit. She's not clear. So she's been not sleeping or she's swollen. I don't know. There's reasons your voice gets hoarse. Maybe you don't sleep. You had too much alcohol. You could be on your menstrual cycle. You could have been screaming. You could have been abusing your voice. Everything sounds the same on those baby vocal cords. Misuse, abuse, and overuse. You're going to sound a little scratchy. Of course, I want to comment on improper singing and improper vocal hygiene, but nothing matters when it's art. Nothing matters when you're expressing something about your heart. It's just that you can't do it every night when you're hoarse. You're going to lose your voice at some point, and that poor baby instrument is going to, you know, be damaged. So she needs to steam, obviously, and she needs to rest. But, the angst in her heart is actually mirrored by the angst in her tone. And our bodies do that sometimes, right? The psychosomatic aspect of things. When you're blocked emotionally, your voice can be blocked. And I know about that from my past and my history. Okay, I have not quite broken down yet. I've held it together. So, she's in her chest voice. She'll give it a little excess air, but mostly she's just She's belting it out, and she's not concerned, which I always say singers can't be concerned because then it takes the art right out of the song. Okay, let's finish it out. We're at 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I guess I'm halfway through.
Peace by piece. Piece by piece, I fell far from the tree. I will never leave her like you left me. And she will never have to wonder her worth. Because unlike you, I'm gonna put her first.
Wow.
He'll never walk away. He'll never walk away. He'll never break her heart. He'll take care of things. He'll love her.
Oh, God. And that little tremoloso in her voice after she broke. That got me. Sorry. But obviously she's not with a track because the piano player just was right there with her when she started that line over. And we all get to be a part of that moment as she processes her pain. And she's pretty much telling him off, isn't she? Wow. To the world. So when you're an artist, you kind of air your dirty laundry, don't you? So now the whole world knows what she grew up with and what she didn't get. And so you have to be really grateful for an artist who's willing to share and bear their soul like that. So that we can see that we're not alone in our pain, or that, you know, crap happens to everybody, or whatever, however you want to look at it. The song is about needing to be loved by your parent. And she's using her own child, and she's saying, I will never, ever be like that. I think I should just stop. I've said enough. But vocally, some devices she's using obviously is belting. And then just singing a little bit in head voice, getting soft there. And that little tiny vibrato is like tremoloso. It makes you feel like you can feel the beating of her heart like a little trembling bird. It's really powerful. Really, it's just the content. I think anybody could be singing this song, even off pitch, and it would make me cry. But it makes me sure love her as an artist for the risk that she's taking. And for bearing her soul, and for telling the truth, and for drawing boundaries as a woman, and setting that model for the rest of the females, mothers, and wives.
Piece by piece, restore my faith.
Everyone's crying.
That a man can be kind and a fudge.
She can't even get through it. Instead of stay, she said great.
Peace by peace.
Okay. And she's getting a standing ovation. She just definitely moved me, and I feel very connected as a human being and as a female to her as a mother. And a sister, because we are all one, aren't we? Anyway, so all the judges are crying. I'm not the only one. I'm just trying to talk through it. I'm half expecting her beautiful, darling, wonderful, perfect husband to walk on. And in a way, I kind of want to do some research now and see what her story is. I know she has another song, Because of You. And I kind of think it's about her mom, like being not being there for her, too. So this little girl next door who started American Idol, who got this whole singing thing off the ground, has changed culture. And instead of her just being some fake, made up, obsessed with image, skinny, dancing, you know, grabbing her body. She is being authentic. She's talking about things that matter. She's still entertaining, but there's substance here. There's substance, and entertainment is great, and joy is great, and upbeat is great. But this type of contribution to culture changes culture, and it's very lasting. And I will definitely watch this again, and I will definitely do research. And I hope that my students and I myself in my art aspire to this type of truth and honesty so that we can transform our superficiality in our culture to be a little bit more full of depth and aim for healing and wholeness and goodness. Okay, I'm going to be done now. Please subscribe. I'll see you on YouTube for the next Voice Teacher Reacts.